Alright, hey, what's going on guys? This is Zephyr. I'm going to show you guys in this video how to set up a buy shop and a sell shop, which I got over here. That will be connected to your scoreboard from the last video, which I will set up there. So let's go ahead and get started. I have two methods for the buy shop, and then there's a couple variations of the same method for the sell shop, but we'll get started with the buy shop. So the first option is basically just showing you how to give yourself a simple item. There's nothing special about it, like just like this. Give myself a diamond, and I want to give myself one. Just like that. But as in Bedrock Edition, you cannot give yourself an item with a custom name or a custom enchant, and that's where the second option, which is this one with the chest, comes into play. So we'll just get this set up real quick, just for an example. So this one has sharpness 3, so I can show you guys. Get rid of this button. So let's go ahead and get started with the first method here. So we're going to want to clear out my inventory a little bit. So the first method, we're going to go ahead and get started. So depending on how you want to lay it out, if you want to, you could lay it out like this, and you could have it behind a wall like that, or you could have it, like this would be your floor, for example, and you could have it like that, and it's going down, and obviously you would have to have it going the opposite way if you want to do it that way. But for this example, we're just going to have it standing straight up, just like that, just for this example. So for the first one, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to do this command here. But we're going to, instead of money, we're going to relate it to our last video, which is the test, which is the one on the side of the screen over here. Let's just go ahead and give myself some money. Add at S test, and then we'll just do 50 bucks, just for an example. So for the first one, what you're going to do, you're going to want to test to see if the player has the right amount of money. So how you're going to do that is you're going to want to do scoreboard players test at P, lowercase p, at P, and then whatever you're testing from. So for this example, the scoreboard that we're testing from is test, which is actually kind of funny that it's test and test here. So if it was a different example, like my other scoreboard, it would be money. But we're just going to go with test for this one. And then you're going to want to do the amount of money that you're testing them for. So this example, we're just going to test them for $10. And then for the second one, for the chain, we're going to want to make sure that this is conditional, because we don't want this command to go, like, to execute or go off or fire unless this one is true. So if this one's true, then this one will happen. So what we'll do is we'll do scoreboard players remove at P, and then we'll do test, and then 10. So the 10 is the amount of money that you're going to be pulling from them. The test right here is just the name of the scoreboard that we're pulling the money from. At P is closest player. And then what we'll do after that, so we'll go up to this one, make it conditional, and then we're going to want to do give at P whatever item you want to give them. So this example, maybe we'll do emerald. And then you want to do 0, and then the amount that you want to do. It's just going to be 1. So we'll just do give at P the name of the item, and then 1. So theoretically, that's on previous output. So if you see, I have 50 bucks over here on the side of the screen. I press this. I go down 10 bucks and it gives me an emerald. And so see, if your score was in the range, then it will remove it and then it'll give you the item. So if I do this a couple more times to get myself out of money, did that one a little bit too fast. And then if I get myself, so now I have 5 and I have no more money. So if I press this, nothing else is going to happen. So then what you can do, is actually that's the first buy option. So we're actually going to go and make the second one. So we're going to just give myself 20 bucks. Now this example is for if you want to give some a player like an enchanted item or an item with a specific name or data value. So what you're going to want to do, just go ahead and set these up. So we're going to want to do 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go ahead and grab the chest here with the sword inside of it. So then what we'll do is you're going to want to do same as these first two before. So we're going to do scoreboard players test at p test is 10. Make this conditional for the second one. Scoreboard players remove at p test 10. Make this one conditional. And then we're going to clone the chest, actually. So we're going to put in tilde, tilde, tilde. So for the first, so the tildes are where you're currently standing. So if I do teleport tilde, which is the x value, tilde, or the second one is the y value, the third one is the z value. So if I do the one next to the middle tilde, which is the up and down, the y, see it teleported me up one block. So we're going to use that to actually clone this chest. So we're going to clone, starting at this, we're going to go up 1, 2. So we're going to put 2. And then when you do the clone command, it's actually cloning an area. So you're going to have to do this again. So tilde, tilde, 2, tilde. So it should be 1, 2, 3. That's your first set of coordinates. 1, 2, 3. That's your second set. And you're going to have to do a third set of tildes, unless you'd prefer to just do an coordinates of where you're actually going to paste the command. So the last three here are going to be where you're going to be pasting the chest. So what we're going to do is we're going to clone it in front here. So we're going to clone it right there. So if we're standing here, if you look up at the coordinates up here, we're going to move up one in the Z direction. So we're going to do one there. And then we're going to want to make this conditional. We're going to actually want to set block, tilde, 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 make this a negative 1, 1, because this is going to actually break the chest, which is going to be right here. So it's going down 1, down on the Y, and then out 1 in the Z coordinate. So it's going to set block that, air, 0, destroy. If you don't do the destroy, it's just going to get rid of the chest, and it won't drop the items. So theoretically, if I press this button, see it cloned the chest and dropped the sword, and it also took away 10 bucks. So if I do that again, gives me 10 more bucks. And see, now that I have no more money, it doesn't work anymore. And making these conditional is very crucial, because if you do this unconditional, if you fire off this impulse command, it's going to go through these chain, and if this isn't conditional, this is going to go off every time. So actually, let's make this one, or I'll make these two unconditional. So even if I don't have enough money, watch, it's still going to drop the sword. So you want to make sure that these are conditional, so that it doesn't work. Alright, so that's the first, or those are the two buy options, and then we're going to move over to the sell shops. So what you're going to want to do is make sure that you have, depending on how you want to do it, if you want to do it sell one item at a time, you're going to want an impulse and a chain. And if it's going to be if you want to have it, let's say you're trying to sell like a stack of diamond blocks, then you're going to want a repeating and then a chain. So let's go over here. Let's get these set up. We'll go like, wrong one there. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to clear closest player and whatever the item is. So let's do diamond underscore block. And then this is where the 0, 1 comes into place. The 0 is the data value, which a lot of items in the game, their data value is 0. So generally just put 0 and then how many of the item you want to do. And so you're going to want to do clear them of one of that item. So clear closest player, which is at P. Item name 0 and then 1. Then for the chain, make it conditional. I want to do scoreboard players add at p test, and let's say diamond block is 100 bucks. You get 100 bucks for that. So what you're going to want to do is then you can do a button, or you can put a lever here or a pressure plate, but make sure this is needs redstone, so it's not always going off. So let's just say if I give myself 3 diamond blocks and I stand on this pressure plate, it should give me $300. Just like that. Perfect. So now that I don't have any more, it doesn't work anymore. And so like if I give myself 3 more, and if I press the button too, it'll work just like that. And the reason that we have the impulse there is, if I copy these, which these are the same as the commands before, but we're just going to make this into an impulse. This is just like if you want to make it more specific, so that players have to press the button. So it's, however you want to set it up, so that it only does one at a time instead of however many they have in their inventory. So see, now I have to press the button each time. It's clearing me of that every time. And those are the cell shops. That should be it. So if you guys like the cell shops and the buy shops that I provided for you guys, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys later. This has been Zephyr. Peace out.